Fiqih Naidu. He was known as the Shahinshah of Indian cricket. And we have great luminaries here, Mr. Ghulam Ahmed, ADI Bara, our Chief Secretary, Dr. Raja Ji. We have got the Managing Director of the Nagarjuna Finance Limited, Mr. Chari. We have got Mr. V.K. Srinivasan. He's also a Principal Secretary, and then he is the great cricket enthusiast. We have Mr. Ashtapotre, and of course, Sai Baba, who is the live wire behind this sports complex. Your reminiscence about the great Colonel Fiqih Naidu.
This is the centenary year of Colonel Fiqih Naidu, and I would recommend each and every sport organization connected with the game to celebrate it in a befitting manner, to pay homage to a very great cricketer India has produced. Unfortunately, in his days, the test cricket was almost negligible. He, if I remember correctly, had played hardly half a dozen test matches because during the war, there was no cricket at all. And in his heydays, India was not recognized as a test country. The Board of Control for Cricket in India came into existence in 1928. If Fiqih Naidu had born then, the story today would have been different. His name was household in India while he was playing in various tournaments conducted in this country. He played in England and made a name. He was the first Indian cricketer to be in the Wisdoms.
I found him to be one of the best captains. I was a very brainy chap. He used to make out the mistakes of the opponents, the batsmen and the bowlers. Apart from his batting, he was also an off-spinner. And he used to taken a lot of wickets in Ranji Trophy matches.
Rajaji with us. Dr. Rajaji has got a long history. Dr. Rajaji, Tamil Nadu and all. Cricket is a part of, as a matter of fact, Madras, Tamil Nadu and the Rajaji family itself. Well, sir, you must have seen Colonel Fiqih Naidu in action. What are your impressions about this great cricketer?
I saw him in action only once, and it was a brilliant innings which I saw at that time. But what I read of Mr. Fiqih Naidu, I think, is far more important than what I saw of him. Fiqih Naidu was probably among the best cricketers which this country has produced. The only tragedy of his life was that he was born too early. If he were born maybe 20 years later, probably he would have been among the various records which are entered in the Wisden today. Because he could play only when he was 37, when he first played a test match. And then again his cricketing career was interrupted due to the World War. I must mention one incident. I believe when he was playing with Constantine came across to him and told him, "You please look after your end, I'll do all the stroking and I'll do all the runs." After 3 or 4 overs, it was Fiqih Naidu who was doing all the running and he was getting all the runs. And then Constantine came over and apologized to him for not having realized the genius of Fiqih Naidu. Then again, in an article, somebody had compared Fiqih Naidu to Bradman. And I think that is what is most important. There was a cricketing genius in everything that he did, in his batting, in his bowling, in his fielding, and in his captaincy. I would be particularly happy if Hyderabad, with the Sport Coaching Foundation, produces a couple of Fiqih Naidus. Then Kankaya Naidu from Machilipatnam would be extremely happy. That is, I think, the most befitting tribute we can give it to him.